New at 11 tonight, it's one of those places you may have driven past without actually knowing what goes on there. But the Sears Shelter at McPherson Park in Greenville is very familiar to senior citizens who've operated it as an activity center for nearly 20 years. Well, that's about to change. The city has other plans for the shelter, and some seniors are not happy about that. The story tonight from News 4's Tim Waller.
There's an art sale this weekend at the Sears Shelter in Greenville. And every last item on display here must go.
You're thinking, oh, we have to move. And it's like leaving family and separating for some of us.
Senior Action, which has ran the shelter for 18 years, offering art classes and other activities for senior citizens, is turning the place over to Greenville's Parks and Recreation Department, which came as a big disappointment to some.
That was probably the biggest shock is, you know, why do this to us? It's kind of the feeling among some of the people.
Even the log cabin gift store that's full of arts and crafts made by seniors must be emptied by the end of the month.
I was surprised, but I guess you just move on. You just move on and maybe something will be better.
But the head of Senior Action says this will be better for both seniors and the city at large.
Every transition is difficult, but in the long run, we know that this will turn out to be a positive thing for them.
Andrea Smith says running the shelter was costing the city and Senior Action $100,000 a year to operate. And the building, she says, was never senior friendly.
You know, handicap accessibility, it was a very steep parking lot, there was a major road that you were having to cross to get into the building.
Smith says classes like painting and basket weaving will be shifted to other Senior Action locations to make room for whatever comes of this place.
We're disappointed, but we will go on.
Tim Waller, WIFF News 4, Greenville.
Dana Souza, director of Greenville Parks and Rec, tells News 4 the shelter will undergo renovations beginning September 1st. After that, he says, a new slate of programs will be offered to people of all ages.